center ice. Gretzky loses the puck. As he had intercepted, now to Yzerman over the line. A shot, he scores!
For 23 years, Detroit fans had the true fortune to experience one of the all-time greats, Steve Yzerman.
What a shot by Yzerman!
At just 21, he would become the Red Wings' leader, the youngest in franchise history.
Number 19, Steve Yzerman!
And he would hold that role longer than anyone in the NHL, becoming one of the best two-way forwards ever to play the game.
Down, Yzerman picks it up. Yzerman, the shot, scores! There it is! Yzerman.
Being a 10-time All-Star and leading the Red Wings to three Stanley Cups along the road assures his legacy. But that road wasn't an easy one. Steve Yzerman came to Detroit on a mission where he encountered obstacles and injuries that would have ended an average player's career. But there's the key. Steve Yzerman is not average.
To me, what separates Steve from everybody else was his mental toughness, his determination, his competitiveness. He had wonderful stick skills and he had great scoring ability, but in the end, it was his passion and all the mental aspect of his game to me that separated him from a lot of players.
Yes! Steve Yzerman gets the goal!
The people of Detroit that got to see him over the 22 years witness something very, very, very special.
He never came out and said it, but I know he played for the fans. I mean, he wanted to earn their respect, and he got their respect. He wanted to make sure he kept it.
Steve's respect for the fans came from his love for the game, a game that he had come to love as a boy in Canada.
I was one of five kids, and was born in British Columbia and lived in a couple of small towns there, and pretty much grew up playing sports year-round, whether it was hockey or soccer or, you know, road hockey, ball hockey of some sort. We played sports all day long. My first memory of hockey was watching games on the weekend with my dad, and I was going to play a sport of some sort, whether it was hockey or not, but hockey was my favorite sport. I wanted to be play in the National Hockey League. That's all I wanted to do.
But at age 10, Steve and his family moved from British Columbia to the suburbs of Ottawa.
For us, you know, getting there right away and joining a hockey team, you got friends immediately, and so that makes the transition easy. My brother's a year older than myself. He started playing a year before I did. I went and watched him play and immediately knew I wanted to play the following year. My first couple of years in the PN, I think a 10-year-old and as a 12-year-old, two teams I played on were tremendous hockey teams, and I played with some, you know, at that time, fantastic hockey players, and we won a lot of games, a lot of tournaments, and you know, I was very fortunate because I learned a lot about the game and was taught a lot by some of the coaches I played for as a youth. I was very lucky at that time.
But boy, when we were younger, there was no one that would block shots in front like Steve would. All he'd do is get the puck and do something that defined the game.
Steve's development would lead him to the Peterborough Petes of the Ontario Hockey League.
Well, that became serious hockey. You know, you're going from minor hockey to playing major junior, and it happened pretty quickly. First sudden, there's scouts and agents, I guess, in the building. And again, it happens pretty quickly because here you are, 14 years old, playing against playing against 14-year-olds, and the only people in the stands really are your families, and within 18 months you're playing in front of a couple of thousand people. It was a big change. A lot's going on over a short period in your life. For me, it was a tremendous learning experience, and I probably could have really done with more time in junior to learn a lot of different parts of the game and really get comfortable in junior. And I was only there in Peterborough for 2 years before coming to Detroit.
The Red Wings franchise had sunk to the lowest of lows. Multiple losing seasons, coupled with their new nickname. Owner Bruce Norris had enough and sold the team to entrepreneur Mike Ilitch. Ilitch and recently new GM Jim Devolano would join forces, with the goal being the Dead Wings extinction.
you know, we had a Detroit boy we were looking at, Pat LaFontaine.
The advantage that LaFontaine had at that time was that he was a local boy. He was an American, he was from Detroit, and he would have been, at that time, a terrific marketing tool that we badly needed.
But that plan was about to change. As LaFontaine went to the Islanders, and Yzerman would fall to the Wings.
I didn't know anything about him other than his name. And when he showed up, he had a red tie on, and that was his claim to fame as far as I was concerned.
Actually, I felt a little bit sorry for him because the reality of professional sports is that you excel in junior hockey or college hockey, you're rewarded by going to one of the worst teams in the game.
They were either trying to make him come along fast or they had that much respect. And after you watch him for a while, you should have respect. He was dedicated.
From that moment on, you think, you know, you start dreaming about the, you know, how things are going to go and that it's going to work out successfully.
When he was 17, we signed him. We sat in the kitchen for 4 hours, my wife and I, in our breakfast nook there. And when he left, I said, holy mackerel, 17 years old. Where did he gain this knowledge, this broad base that he has? He's talking like an adult.
A new challenge for Steve and the Red Wings front office.
Well, I'm really excited right now for the opportunity to remain here, but really learn how the business is run, and to me it's very exciting.
When he's given an assignment and he's given a job, he takes it serious and he wants to go out and give it 100%. He doesn't know any other way.
That approach is what has made Steve Yzerman one of the greats.
They've had Gordie Howe and Ted Lindsay and Alex Delvecchio, and to have Steve that long with the C winning, great for the city. Great for everybody there. Congratulations.
The greatest thing about sports is we always have a debate of who is the greatest, and everyone has their reason for why that person should be the greatest, whether it was Gordie Howe or Bobby Orr or Steve Yzerman or Mario Lemieux, Mark Messier, the list goes on and on. And the common denominator that they all have is that they were champions, and they became champions by being unselfish and good teammates. And I think that any person that ever played against Steve or played with him will tell you that.
The people out there that don't know him, he, as much as you have in your mind's eye of who he is, he's a better person than you could ever imagine.
For 23 years, Steve Yzerman was that certain combination of skill, determination, and leadership.
I wish I could open up the bottle and look at the formula. I could make a lot of money selling it.
He did it all. He became a player that's, I think, revered throughout the league for his leadership qualities, his passion. He's got 3 championships. He was able, in the end, to accomplish all his goals, and I think that was really a testament to his determination and his passion and his love for the game.
For the most part, it's exactly what I had hoped for in a hockey career and in the NHL. I dreamed of winning the Stanley Cup. I dreamed of winning multiple Stanley Cups, and we were fortunate to win 3. All I wanted to be as a boy growing up was a player in the National Hockey League, a hockey player, and I was able to accomplish that. So I really feel good about you know, the important things, I guess what really became important to me, I was able to accomplish.
Just a shade under 6 foot, you know, 180 pounds, let's say. And number 6, all-time scoring. I mean, I think that's a remarkable achievement. I mean, out of the thousands of players that have played the game over all those years, this guy comes in, he's number 6. Boy, not too shabby. I just want to say, Stevie, job well done, son. Job well done.